Lockheed Martin revealed an in-development, longer-range variant of the AGM-158 cruise missile, the XR, or Extreme Range. This announcement took place at the Air, Space, and Cyber 2024 event, the U.S. Air Force Association's largest annual gathering near Washington, D.C., a venue often used for major official disclosures and product promotions. While the XR version of this weapon has been in development for some time, this is the first time that we've seen it and have gotten official details about its configuration. In this video, Defense Updates reports on the new Lockheed Martin AGM-158 Extreme Range XR. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. John Hill, Lockheed Martin's General Manager for Air Dominance and Strike Weapons, stated regarding the new missile, "I would say that the 158XR really is a story of innovation and anticipating the needs of the warfighters. It leverages an existing production line, production processes. When we think of XR, think of that as extreme range. What it really does is it stretches the existing JASSM and LRASM family, that outer mold line, to give us more fuel, essentially. And that buys us the range that we need and that the warfighters need." He further noted, "It leverages modularity. So while we're in doing modifications, we're going digital. We're leveraging the existing mission planning structure along with the existing software architecture. And as you know, JASSM or LRASM benefit from inline upgrades and fixes as they come down the production line. So for me, being part of a production line where you can incorporate changes that the warfighters ask for in stride is a pretty powerful thing. So this weapon leverages all of those really great things, and it's a great option for the Air Force to consider for the future." The XR has the familiar trapezoidal cross-section and low observable shaping of the JASSM and LRASM, but this new variant has an increased length. It would be able to carry 1,000 pounds or about 450 kilogram warhead. The original A variant of the JASSM is supposed to have a range of well over 230 miles or 370 kilometers, while the ER variant boosts that dramatically to over 500 miles or 805 kilometers. The XR is thought to be able to reach Tomahawk-like distances of around 1,000 miles or 1,600 kilometers. The missile could potentially reduce its warhead size to accommodate additional fuel, further extending its range. Like JASSM, XR variant will be stealthy. It'll feature low observable outer coatings and reduced infrared and electromagnetic signature. Lockheed Martin is specifically calling this new cruise missile variant AGM-158XR, not the JASSM-XR, as its enhanced range could find its way to the LRASM. Viewers may note that LRASM or AGM-158C is the anti-ship variant. Lockheed's Michael Rothstein, Vice President of Air Weapons and Sensors, stated three key advantages that come from range enhancement. "You know, operationally, I would kind of put it in three things I think this brings relevance to. The first is a threat. We all know the threats continue to evolve and ranges continue to grow. When you can have more standoff range and still do the kind of exquisite targeting and get a survivable kind of weapon that JASSM and LRASM has proven itself to be at greater standoff range, that's good for the warfighter. The second benefit it does is that as you are dropping things at increased standoff range, instead of having to drive in farther to the release point, you're now going back to refuel, rearm, and turn your next sortie. So it helps build operational tempo for the warfighter, because now they can generate more sorties in a day, put more mass across the target if they need to do that with other weapons, or other XRs, or whatever it may be. The third key operational standpoint is refueling. We all know tanker bills and refueling is always a factor for our aviation forces, you know, particularly in something like a China theater. In every theater, tankers are always a hard thing. So again, if you have farther release points, that's less gas you got to drive. That's less or fewer tankers that you need for that given mission set. And those tankers are then freed up, or that gas is freed up, to do other things. Can't get into the specifics, but we've done the operational analysis of all of those things on the ranges and the threat, the tankers, and certainly there's benefit there to the warfighter that's very, very significant. Lockheed Martin claims that the incremental upgrades applied to the AGM-158 family will be directly adaptable to the XR variant. A key advantage highlighted is that the missile was designed to utilize the same production line. The company aims to reach a production rate of 1,100 missiles per year in the near future, with the flexibility to produce either ER or XR versions based on customer demand. To add rapid production, Lockheed Martin has introduced automated processes and digital simulations in its manufacturing facilities. According to the company, a new 225,000 square foot facility opened in 2022, which includes robotics and automated systems designed to increase production efficiency while ensuring quality control. These advancements, Lockheed claims, will not only accelerate production but also allow the integration of innovations like the AGM-158XR more quickly. All existing platforms that carry JASSM or LRASM can carry XR, aside from the F-16 since it would be too big. So technically, F-15E and F-15EX, F-A-18E and F Super Hornets, as well as bombers like B-52 and B-1B, would be able to carry this missile, providing excellent platform compatibility. As of now, the new AGM-158XR is being developed only through internal research and development funding. But it's likely that the U.S. Department of Defense will be interested in this weapon, since the pretty long range, coupled with stealthy design and sizable warhead, would be a very good proposition. It remains to be seen how things pan out in the coming days.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.